Hi, today is going to be a little bit different. I am not going to talk about books. I'm going to talk about booktubers. These are some of my absolute favorite, most influential booktubers, and I have them kind of ranked. I have a most missed because they've stopped uploading category. I have a I never miss a video category. I have a I find these people incredibly enjoyable, but I sometimes miss a video category. And I have a honorable mentions. I subscribe and I watch like maybe a fourth of their content videos. And then I have a not book but absolutely fabulous list of creators. I'm going to try to link as much as I can down in the description below, but I'm not sure exactly how much it's going to let me. But I do have, like, just so you know, like, I have set and ready to go everybody's links and everything, just copy and pasted in there, but I don't know how much it's going to let me put in. So very quickly, I'm going to put up pictures of everybody who I mention, and I'm not gonna give a lot of information about them. I just want you to go and check them out. I'm planting a seed of curiosity here. These are some of my absolute favorites. However, if you are a person who is following me and you did not make it on this list and you are watching this video, A, thank you, and B, no snub intended. So here we go. These are the people who I absolutely miss. They used to upload regularly. They have either fallen off the face of the earth or they have announced, for very good reasons, that they are not currently uploading videos, and I miss them terribly. So those four people are Alicia Reads, Faith at Faithfully Geeky, Liz at For Booking Out Loud, and Lauren Wade, who hopefully will come back, has posted a few videos this year, but left because she had the most adorable daughter named Edith on the face of the earth. These are the people who I never miss. I never miss one of their videos. If I see that they've uploaded a video, I watch it. So that is Allie at Allie V, Kelsey at Bookishly Nerdy, Katie at Books and Things, Carrie. Carrie gets double duty here because I watch Carrie at Carrie Cakes and Carrie at Carrie Can Read. Christiane Jones, Charlotte at Quainy Reads, Emma at Drinking by My Shelf, and Emma Tobias, Erin at Erin Go Read, Gabby at Gabby Reads, Hannah at Hannah's Books, Ivy at Ivy's Library Card. I love her TBR game. Leanne at Literary Diversions, Naomi at Naomi's Bookshelf, Claudia at Spencer's Library, who isn't really uploading right now, but probably will. Holly at Spoopy Halls. Sydney at Sydney Bookworm. And Amy at Zoe Beck. If you go and check all these people out, you will see, or if you already do watch them, you will see that they are incredibly different as far as their communication styles. I mean, some of them are very, like, atmospheric, very cinematic, very, they are creating a masterpiece of editing and perspective. And some are like me. We just, like, turn on a camera and go, hi, I read. And I like both of those vibes from my videos. Next is a list of people who I find, of creators who I find enjoyable, and I would say I probably watch 3/4 of the videos that they put up. Some kinds of videos that I don't like to watch from anybody, they just don't appeal to me, are unhauls, read with me's, reading sprints, library book hauls. These are things that I don't really find incredibly interesting, but these creators put those kinds of things up on occasion, but also they put up other kinds of videos, which I do enjoy an awful lot. And all of them recommend books that are outside of my comfort zone and my norm. And so I get a lot of inspiration from that. So without further ado, Allie at Allie's Other Book Life. Oh, sorry, Allie's Other Life. Allie's Other Life, as stated here in the picture. Books with Leo, Krista at Books and Jams, Beth at Books Nest, Monique at Book Witch Reviews, Chantel Reads All Day, Chantel at Chantel Reads All Day. She used to be Chantel at Chantel's Intentional Life, if you know her under that name. Jean at Jean's Bookish Thoughts, Jen Campbell, Katie Coulson, and Jordan at The Lost Reader. And then these are people who often put up videos that I enjoy, but I would say I only actually watch about a fourth of what they put up. Sometimes that has to do with the quantity. Like some of these are very frequent posters. Good on you. I am not one of those. Sometimes it has to do with the length of their videos. Some of these people regularly put up videos that are over an hour or two long, but they put up infrequently. Sometimes it has to do with content, but these are people who I watch on the regular, but don't watch all of their videos, and I really enjoy them, and I suggest you give them a try. So some of these are very large, like they have a lot of followers, and some of them are pretty small. So we've got all kinds here. I've got Emma at Emmy. I've got Carolyn Marie Reads, that's Carolyn. Ashley at A Frolic Through Fiction. Olive at A Book Olive. Lexi at Alexander Roslin. Ariel at Ariel Bissette. Now, Ariel Bissette, I never watch, this is so weird, I never ever watch her book content. I am all about her house refab content though, absolutely love it. I regularly watch her, like she just redid her entryway, ate it up. I ate it up. Anyway, Erin at Booked and Busy, Kayla at Books and Lala, Kira at Kira Foster, Gavin at How to Train Your Gavin, Lauren at Lauren in the Books. Now I watch Lauren at Lauren in the Books Vlogmas religiously. Miranda at Miranda Mills, Olivia at Olivia Reads a Latte, Reagan at The Peruse Project, Simon at Savage Reads. This is my list of not bookish but still fabulous. I highly recommend these people to watch and enjoy. I love watching Julia Montague's videos at an American Vice Countess. She recently started doing these partnered videos where she's being sponsored, like sponsored videos. And I know that this is to try and like upkeep and help British heritage, etc., etc. But I've been I've been watching her before she was doing that. And I just really enjoy her videos about being an American from the Midwest who's married to British aristocracy and kind of that inside look. Really enjoy that. And also right now she's doing this series where she goes to these older houses and kind of shows what it's like behind the scenes to live in these British heritage houses. Really, really interesting. Absolutely love it. She also did a series that I watched over the summer where she purchased a house, I think, that they turned into an Airbnb in Italy, which I also really loved. So, Julia Montague, great content. Giselle Waldner is a woman who records her everyday life. She usually does one vlog a week. Her everyday life as a Hutterite in Canada. And I have followed a couple of different people who do this, but I have only stayed with Giselle. There's something really sweet about her spirit. She's super happy and joyful, but also real and gets frustrated and loves to read and has the most adorable dog and really great friendships. And I don't know, I just really enjoy kind of her slice of life explanation of her day to day. Like it's just really beautiful and she puts together a beautiful video as well. So highly recommend Giselle Waldner. Jay Swanson, same as what I can say about Giselle Waldner, except that Jay Swanson is an American who has, expatriated? I don't know, like moved to permanently, I think, France. And he lives in Paris and he just kind of does his life. Now, Jay was keeping up an insane schedule. He was posting an Instagram a day. He was posting a video like every other day. And he has pulled back in a very healthy way. But I really, really love his videos. Kayla Stroop, who doesn't post very often, but Kayla and her husband purchased this really great old mansion and they've been redoing it and their style is kind of weird and quirky. And I really, really love watching her videos when she does put them up, but you can also follow her on Instagram for more frequent updates. Kirsten and Jörg, the dynamic duo from Germany who live in England right now, and they post mostly travelogues, but I found them during the pandemic lockdowns and they couldn't go anywhere and they still created great content. They are lovely, lovely people. And I really, like, I feel all warm and cozy when I watch their videos. Then there is Nikki Positano, who is a British woman married to an Italian man, and she's been living in Italy with her family for over 20 years. And she posts the most amazing vlogs. Right now she's doing Vlogmas, and so she's posting very regularly, but usually she posts, I think, once a week. And just really love that slice of life in Italy view. Somers in Alaska. Is it Somers or Summers? I think it's Summers, but it's S-O-M-E-R-S. In Alaska, I really enjoy their videos. They are like talk about and show their life in Alaska. They live in North Pole, Alaska, which is super fun to watch. I don't know why, but I love it when they do shopping videos, like when they go into Safeway or Fred Meyer, and I'm like, I know those places. Wait, they have those in Alaska? Sorry to people in Alaska. I am a world traveler. I know that things are not what we think they are from where we stand. It still shocks me. So super fun to watch their family and to watch them talk, you know, like, I think it was in August that they were like, the snow is coming. So just really fun to watch them. Caleb and Kim at the Second Empire Strikes Back. They too have purchased an older house and they are restoring it. I think they're in Ohio and they are restoring it, and you get to see the entire process. It's very slow going, but like, I love it when he goes to find like original plumbing and things like that. I really find it absolutely fascinating. I never thought that I would find paint stripping so enthralling, but I absolutely do when Caleb and Kim are doing it. So totally love them. Give them a watch. And I actually have been pleased to say that I've been there since the beginning and I've watched their video grow from, I mean, their subscribers. I've watched their subscribers grow from like 100 to 122,000 or something. Like, they have an amazing number of followers and it happens so quickly, but it's because the content they're putting up is just really enthralling and unique and wonderful. So there you have it. These are my favorite booktubers, my most influential booktubers. These are not the booktubers or the only booktubers that I watch, but they are the ones that I suggest you watch. Enjoy, and if you have a channel and I don't watch you, or you don't know if I watch you, please link it down below. If you have a channel and I do watch you and I didn't mention you again, I'm sorry, link yourself down below. You know, BookTube is all about, in my mind, community. That is what I am here for. And that is what I want to foster. And so I decided this year to do this video of, not necessarily, it's, yes, I recommend every single one of them, every single one. But it's more like, this particular video is more about like, these are the people who influence my creation on a regular basis. And I appreciate them so much, everything they do. I hope to grow up and be like them someday. So thank you to all the creators who are putting themselves out there. Happy holidays to everyone, no matter what holiday you celebrate or don't celebrate. And I will see you later.